Should you give while you're getting out of debt? That is a question for the ages, and one that Mauricio and I fundamentally disagree on. Hi, I'm Wendy Valencia. My husband Mauricio and I are on our debt-free journey to pay off more than $300,000 worth of debt. The process will be long, but we are doing our very best to pay it off as quickly as we can so we can have the rest of our lives to live a debt-free lifestyle. If that is something that interests you, feel free to click that big old red subscribe button down below. So recently, Jennifer M. posted these questions to us. I know a huge part of your debt is from helping your in-laws, and you talk about how you have changed your giving methods. Can you talk about how you would have done things differently or how you will do things differently in the future when it comes to giving for your family? So if you are new to my channel, you may or may not know that we racked up $300,000 in debt, but not in the traditional way. It didn't really involve crazy spending and lots of shopping and piling credit card debt. I won't get into all the details here. I'll link a video up in the eye in the sky, but essentially one third of our $300,000 worth of debt is mine and Mauricio's debt, which covered our car, a tax issue, and Mauricio's college loan. The vast majority of the last two thirds of the debt came from us helping family members out. We never stopped to think how our generosity would impact our future finances. It wasn't that we didn't do the math. We always did the math and we could always make the payments. The problem was that we never thought about the long-term impact on our financial choices. So knowing what we know now, would we do it again? Yes and no. Would we still pay 100% out of pocket for facial reconstructive surgery for Mauricio's sister without a second thought? Would we still have paid off Mauricio's parents' debt and fixed some pretty intense safety issues with their house? Absolutely. Would we still bring Mauricio's sister and her husband to the United States to learn English and then go to college? Without a doubt. But if we could go back in time, what we would do first is when we arrived in Mexico, we would have immediately started paying off debt. We could have easily paid off our debts at that point without batting an eye, easily in a year. I can't tell you exactly how much we owed when we first got to Mexico, but it couldn't have been more than $40,000 or $50,000. Wine break. If we had paid off the debt when we first got to Mexico, we could have pretty much cash flowed everything the entire time we were there. We certainly would have planned better and looked for other financial options before taking out loans. So that's how we would have dealt with the past, but let's talk about the present. I recently watched one of Dave Ramsey's videos on tithing versus offerings and whether it's a good idea to give tithes and offerings while in the debt-free process. I'll go ahead and link that video up here in the eye in the sky. It was super interesting to hear his opinion on that. If you don't have time to watch that video, basically what he said is tithing always while on the early baby steps, if that is what your religion believes, and then no offerings until you have made it to the later baby steps. His logic for those statements was if you spread yourself too thin, you can't help yourself or you can't help anyone else well. You need to be in a position financially where you can actually afford to help people without doing damage to yourself, which is exactly the problem that Mauricio and I had. And that argument is actually a really valid argument. So my opinions, tithing versus offering. Tithing, as you know, is a tenth. It's 10% of your take home, your gross. However you choose to calculate 10%, that is to go to your church. And I'll tell you, this is exactly where Mauricio and I disagree on giving. See, Mauricio grew up, for all intents and purposes, as an evangelical Christian. And so this is what he truly believes. Tithing is just what you do. And me, I don't like to be told to do anything. In fact, I would rather give 20% of my salary as an offering than give 10% because I'm told I have to. Also, I don't like being asked for money, so don't ask me for money if you actually want it, because 100% of the time, my answer will be no, because I gotta come up with the idea to give you money on my own. I think the greater issue here might be that I just don't like being told what to do. Okay, back on track. So what's an offering? The dummy definition of this is it is a gift or a contribution, and we'll just leave it at that, nice and simple. So tithes and offerings for us. You all know that we don't discuss our giving category on this channel for just a whole host of reasons. But what falls under our giving category? Money we give to the church, money we give to charities, any sort of donation at all, any sort of gifts, including gifts for Melina's friends, except for gifts for Melina and Christmas gifts, because I like to do videos about those, and the money that we give to my parents. So giving is something I believe in, truly believe in 100%. But unfortunately, because of the nightmarish financial situation we've gotten ourselves in and this painful debt process, we have limited our giving significantly. While limiting our giving is something I hate doing, I know that this is the smartest thing for us, because in 10 years, we will be able to give so much more without ever worrying. So in the future, how will we deal with giving? We will have sinking funds for sure for a whole host of giving categories. We will plan way in advance for larger giving. And before we give any significant quantity of money, we're going to look at the full financial implications of what we are doing. What goals will it inhibit? How long is a reasonable amount of time to get there? Are we being logical in our process to give? Or maybe are there other options we should be considering? But most importantly, we will never use debt as a tool for giving again. Period. So are you guys giving while you're on the baby steps? I'd love to hear from y'all down in the comments down below. So leave me a note. Let me know. Are you giving? Do you believe in tithing? Do you, anything? I'd love to hear your take on this. So I'll see you in the next one. See ya.